katarannu gariyah vismah katarannu gariyah yadva jayema yadivano jayeyuh yane vahatvana jijivishamah Tevastita pramukhe dhartarashtraha pramukhe dhartarashtraha karpanya dosho pahata svabhavah pruchyami tvam dharma sammuda chetaha यस्यान् निश्चितं ब्रूहि तन्मे शिष्यस्तेहं शादिमां त्वां प्रपन्नम् नहि प्रपश्यामि ममापनुद्यात् See, after nahi, there is pra. So pra, before that, give some stress. Nahi prapashyami mama panudyat.
Nahi prapashyami mama
panudyat. Yachokamuchoshanam indriyanam. Avapya bhumavasa patna mruddham Dha is to be given stress. Avapya bhumavasa patna mruddham Because there are two, the and the, huh? Rajyam suranam api chadipatyam So, Arjuna is now telling Lord Krishna that katham bhishma maham sankhe dronancha madhusudana He says, oh Madhusudana, you who are the destroyer of Madhu, the demon Madhu and he tells him How can I kill Bhishma and Drona in this battlefield? For you to kill the demon Madhu was okay. But for me, these people are, one is my grandsire, one is my teacher. These people who are actually who deserve to be respected by, because they are my grandfather and my teacher, they deserve to be respected. And in that place, you are telling me to kill them with arrows? How is it possible? Then he says, rather than killing them, what is good for me? For me it is better that I go and seek bhiksha. Rather than killing these people, it will be better that I lead a life of a sannyasi. But then he says, and what is going to come out of this battle? We do not even know what will be the outcome. Na chaitad vidma katarannu gariyah. What is the better? Katarat. Katarat means which is the better of the two? Which one? That we win or that they win? Which will be the better result? That also we do not know. See, now he suddenly feels that the outcome of the battle, whether we win or they, which will be the good one, that we do not know. And without whom we do not wish to live, those Sons of Dhritarashtra are right before us. So, even if we win, we don't want to live without them. Then why should we fight? Then after saying all this, you know, after giving expression to his bottled up emotion, now he sees some clarity. Now comes the clarity. You know, sometimes you yourself do not know what is really puzzling you. there is something definitely, but you are not sure of what that is. You can't pinpoint. Similarly, after saying all this, Arjuna suddenly clicked upon his problem. Now he has hit upon the real problem. He says, Karpanya dosho pahatas vapavaha. He says, O Lord, now I know that my nature is totally taken over by Krupanata. Krupanata means miserliness. And what kind of miserliness is this? Karpanya dosho pahatas vapavaha. My nature is taken over by Krupanata. This last time we discussed, but this is the very important, we touched upon this last time, but since this is the problem because of which Bhagwan gave the Upadesha, so we will look into this again. He says, Krupanata is my problem. This is my main problem. See, Arjuna could make out, diagnosis is there by him, it's, by him itself. He says, I am suffering from the dosha of Krupanata. Krupanata means miserliness. When you have, see here, Madhusudan ji says, Nas yaha svalpam api vittakshatim na kshamate sa krupanaha. One who cannot even tolerate even little bit of expenditure of money is called krupana. Means who cannot part with his property, even little bit of. Here he says, I'm suffering from this miserliness. He indicates two things. That so far I have not used my intellect. So far I have not made the correct use of my intellect. And secondly, because of this, there is something which perhaps I possess but I do not know. See, he says, I do not know my real nature. Because Arjuna has been brought up in such an environment. Yudhishthira is there, satsanga may be going on, and they were in exile for a long time. So they may be doing satsanga of rishis also. So something he knows that I do not know the reality of this world, the reality of myself, reality of Ishvara. There is something spiritual which I do not know, and because of that all my problems have arisen. He has hit upon his problem. And in Shruti also, they say, as I said last time, Yajnavalkya ji in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad points out to the same thing. Yoma etat aksharam gargi aviditva preti asmat loka preti sa krupanaha. One who departs from this world without knowing the nature of the self. Aksharam means that which doesn't perish. Without knowing this, if one goes away, then that is Krupanata. So Arjuna seems to know. He says, there is something which I have overlooked. So far in my life, I have overlooked something. Something very fundamental has bypassed me. And this is the real thing. Because of this, he says, Pruchyami tvam dharma sammuda chetaha. Because of this, I am now confused about my topical problem also. Topical problem means this day-to-day problems which occur in everybody's life. People get confused in them because of the fundamental problem. If you do not know the real thing, lasting thing, and that which is nityam, then it is very likely that sooner or later you will be caught up by the daily or incidental problems. You will not be able to decide what is to be done, to be or not to be. What should be done in this situation? Maybe some, if the problem is not too serious, then maybe you may find a solution. That was happening so far. If the topical problems are not too serious, and if the fundamental problem is not hit upon you, then you may find solutions. But when the unhappiness which is there inside becomes very, very prominent, it becomes so prominent that you cannot proceed, then you become confused about even small things. You do not make correct judgments about small things also. This is what happened to Arjuna. It is impossible, we cannot even imagine that Arjuna making such a decision that I don't want to fight. We cannot imagine, but still this has happened. Why? Because something else has taken over him. For the first time in his life, he realized that I don't know anything. I have dharma, artha and kaam are not everything in life. This now he realized. So far he was working for kama, working for artha and working for dharma also. But he now realized that these three are not enough. There is something else which should be taken care of first. Without that, there is no direction in life. This he realized. And that is why he now wants to address to that problem. So as we said, you know, there are two kinds of problems in life. One is fundamental and another one is topical or incidental. When one has not paid attention to the fundamental problem of life, one has not solved that, then sooner or later you will get puzzled in the topical problems. You will get sooner or later, as I said. So that is now what Arjuna realizes. And that is why he says, Shishyasthenam Shadimam Tvam Prapannam. And that is why, O Krishna, I have now become your, I now want to surrender to you, I now surrender to you and become your student. This also shows that Arjuna knows how Guru Upasadhanam should be done. That also he knows. See, because he is going very methodically. Even in his this confusion, even in his this grief, he is going with a method. He knows how to approach a teacher. So far Lord Krishna was his friend. So this occasion had not arisen. But now he sees teacher in his friend, teacher in his charioteer. And in himself he sees a student. He sees not a warrior, but he sees a student. And they say that in the olden days, even now also, but in the olden days there was a vidhi of how to approach a teacher. In Mundaka Upanishad also we say, there was Shaunaka, he was a very big gruhastha, very big man in the society, very well learned and everything. But he also approaches the teacher. Who was his teacher? Angirasa. Angirasa was his teacher. And when he wanted the answer of Tasminnu Bhagavo Vignate Sarvamidam Vignatam Bhavati. He wanted to know something, knowing which everything becomes known. Means that was the fundamental problem there. He was sort of looking for an answer by which everything would be known. Here for Arjuna the problem is, but all this is same only. So this Shaunaka also approached his teacher. Vidhivat upasannaha. Vidhivat means with a method. Method means very humbly you go to a teacher, bow down and present your problem. And expressly say that I am now your student, please teach me. There was a method in the olden days. So Arjuna seems to know this. He has those samskaras in him. So in the same manner he approached. Otherwise there was no need to tell Lord Krishna that I am your student. Shishyasteham. He need not have said. But he said. Why? Because he is aware of that sampradaya. Sampradaya or guru upasadana. How to approach it. He seems to know. And that is why he says this. Shishyasteham shadima. Shadima means teach me. Teach me. So he says this. And see, he seems to be unconsciously aware that what I lack is not something which can be gained in the usual manner. By doing karmas, I will not be able to acquire that. Because he was very confident of his capacity. And that all he had tried, what he could do with his arms, that he had tried. But now he seems to know. He has that inkling, some insight, that what I now want is something that I have to learn. Something which knowledge will be able to give me. And not acquisition. Means it is not It is not something which I have to really go and work for and get it with my karma. But it is something that I do not know, and that I have to learn from someone. So knowledge is the solution and not karma. That also he is not sure, but he seems to know that now knowledge is my solution. Because he says, yat shreya syat, yat nishchitam shreya syat, tanme bruhe. Because he said, what I want is, he says, give me that. Yat nishchitam shreya syat. He says, my problem is karpanya, krupanata, and from that has arisen confusion about what I should do it in the present. But now, that which is definite, that you please tell me. So that also he knows, that what I have so far worked for is not definite. And the means that I have employed are also not definite. See, nishchitam means that when you employ a sadhana, by doing a sadhana, the result that you get should also be what? Nishchitam. But some in life we are not sure. He knows that so far I have tried so many sadhanas, but the result that I have got is what kind of result? Not, it is not immortal, it is perishable. See, supposing I tell you, we are suffering from some disease. Then we try a medicine. But the medicine, what kind of medicine? It is not atyantika sadhana. Because you may, the medicine may work or may not work. Okay? One thing. The sadhana that is there, medicine is there. But it may work, it may not work. And supposing it works, then also you are not sure whether the disease will again not arise, or it may again arise. You never know. So that way, you see how uncertainty is there in sadhana also and in sadhya also. You try medicine, but it may work, it may not work. And even if it works, it may work temporarily. Again, some problems arise and doctor will say, get and go and do MRI or this and that. And then again you find, oh, this problem has arisen again. So Arjuna says, I don't want this kind of solutions. I don't want to go for the sadhana which is perishable and by which I am not sure of getting the lasting solution. So what now Arjuna wants is lasting solution. And the means also should be such which can bring about a lasting solution. Understand? He wants the sadhana should be such which can bring about lasting solution, which will solve his problem once and for all. It should not arise after 15 days or arise after 20 days. See, this also he knows, people do not know this. We keep on trying things one after other. We go for the same things also, thinking that it will bring an end to my solution. See, we do things thinking that this will bring about an end. Otherwise we would not do. But we do that shows that there is no clarity inside about the sadhana and also about the sadhya. We are not sure of what we want, and secondly, we are not sure of the sadhana also. Arjuna seems to have understood both. He says that I want such a sadhana which will definitely give me what I want. Not temporary solutions, but permanent solutions. And he also knew, some inkling he has got, some not inkling, but some insight, that there should be such a sadhana which is not, means the sadhana should be such which will bring about a lasting solution, but there cannot be such a sadhana in this world which can bring about a lasting solution. There is no such thing in this world which can bring about permanent solution except by learning. And that is why he has surrendered to his. So he knows that knowledge is the only solution. What I mean to say is that he has understood that knowledge will bring about an end to my problem. and no karma, no acquisition. This he has understood. The importance of vidya, the importance of knowledge. And that is why for the first time in his life, he really surrendered. So far he never surrendered in this manner. In this manner, he never surrendered to Lord Krishna. And he says, nahi prapashyami. What? He says, hi prapashyami mama apanudyat yat chokam uchoshanam indriyanam. He says, even if I get bhumo asapatna ruddham, even if I get unrivaled kingdom of this earth, even if I get unrivaled kingdom of this earth, or what he says, even if I get kingdom of heavens, suranam api suranam adhipatyam cha, even the kingdom or the lordship of the heavens, which is not possible, but even if I get that, then also nahi prapashyami, I do not see that yat mama indriyanam uchoshanam shokam, that which can bring about an end to the shoka or the grief which is now troubling my senses, troubling my whole being, that will go, that I do not see. None of the things which will bring about an end to my problem. Even if I see, as we saw in the Ittari Upanishad, he says, yuvasya sadhu yuva dhyayakaha ashishto dradishto balit manusha ananda. What is the manusha ananda? The happiness of this world is that if you are young and if you have got everything, you are fit, and if you have got everything, then it is one degree of happiness of this world. That kind of happiness Arjuna is pointing to. He says, even if I get this, there won't be any solution to my problem. So please solve my problem by teaching. That he said. And now Lord Krishna Sanjaya is reporting. He says, Sanjaya uvacha eva muktva rushikesham gudakesha parantapah nayotsya iti govindam This now Sanjaya is reporting to Dhritarashtra. Eva muktva rushi kesham kuda keshav parantapah. He says, Parantapa, he says, hey Rajan, means, O king, or it is a sambodhan to Gudakesha. Gudakesha parantapah evam rishikesham uktva. Gudakesha, one who has won over his nidra, one who has won over his sleep. You know, he was very hardworking person, Arjuna, who had control over his sleep also. So he says, one who has won over his sleep, or gudakayaha ishaha, or he had lovely hair. So that is why also he was called Gudakesha. Such a Gudakesha, having said this to Rishikesham, evam uktva Rishikesham is given in second vibhakti, which means that he told this, having told this to Rishikesham, tushrim babuvaha, he sat down. What? Having said what? Na yotsya iti govinda. He says, I will not fight. Having said this, he sat down quietly in his chariot. This is what Sanjaya is reporting to Dhritarashtra. But Rishikesha, the word Rishikesha also suggests something. That Rishikesha means one who is the lord of all our sense organs and antakarana. To such a Rishikesha, Arjuna said this. As if Sanjaya seems to say that now Lord Krishna also knows his problem very well. Rishikesha, because he is residing right inside and is aware of what is going on in Arjuna. To such a Rishikesha, Lord Krishna, Arjuna presented his case, and now he sat down. Sat down now means it means that he is waiting for a reply. He is waiting for his teacher's response. He is waiting. He did not run away. See very beautifully in the same line he says, Sanjaya says, he says, I will not fight. And then he sat down there. What does it mean? If he did not want to fight, he could have gone away. Taking up his bow and arrow, he could have left. But he did not leave. Why? He sat there itself, waiting for Lord Krishna to speak. And he is confident that he will speak. He is confident that Lord Krishna will speak means teach. That is why he sat down over there. Plus, one more thing is that Arjuna is now, even though he has come to fight, but Lord Krishna could see that he is an adhikari. Adhikari of Vidya should have all the all Shamadhi Shatkar Sampati, Viveka, Vairagya, Mumukshuta, then Shraddha, Samadhanam, all this Sampati, sixfold qualities should be possessed by an adhikari. Arjuna has got all this. In all this lecture that he gave, Viveka was there. Of course, little bit misplaced, but Viveka was there, Vairagya was there, Shraddha is also there, and Tivra Mumukshuta. So much of Mumukshuta. So all this Lord Krishna could see. So it is now an ideal case, or the standard case of a student and teacher. Only thing is venue is little bit different. In other cases, the venue should have been in a forest, or on the banks of Ganges, or in some ashrama. But here the venue is unheard of. Venue is such a, that it is never heard of. It is a battlefield. Venue is battlefield. And both of them are in the dress of warriors. Of course, not Lord Krishna, but still. But the situation is slightly different. But inner mood is like that of the teacher and the student. So that has now taken place. Then one more verse Sanjaya says in the 10th verse. Tamuvacha Rishikeshah Prahasanniva Bharata Prahasanniva Senayorubhayor Madhye Vishidantamidam Vachah. Now, Sanjaya says, one more verse is there. Sanjaya says, Bharata. Now, Bharata means this is an address to Dhritarashtra, because he is the king. So, Sanjaya is addressing Dhritarashtra. Oh, Bharata, Rishikesha is in the first case. So, it means Rishikesha, Ubayoho Senayoho Madhye Tam Vishidantam Prahasan Iva Idam Vachaha Uvacha. What it means is, O Bharata, Rishikesha said to whom? Tam means to Arjuna. What kind of Arjuna? Vishidantam Arjunam. One who was grieving. To such an Arjuna, Rishikesha, and where? Senayoho Upayoho Madhye. In the battle, or in the midst of the two armies, Rishikesha Tam Uvacha. He said this verse. So Sanjaya is saying to Dhritarashtra that, O king, Lord Krishna or Rishikesha did not ignore Arjuna. Did not ignore him. And he did not say, if you did not want to fight, why did you come? Go back. And I will also go back. And we will fold up all this. But why did you bring me in this? Why did you put me in this predicament? my whole prestige is now is at stake. No such thing. He did not ignore. Of course, in the first, he will now be saying certain, he will be now rebuking Arjuna, but still he did not ignore. Teacher never or should not, never ignores an adhikari. This is also a very important thing in Shastra. That otherwise, these teachers, you know, they are happy and satisfied with their own selves. But when they see an adhikari, when they see a deserving student, one who has mumuksha, one who has jignyasa, then it is said that such teachers, of course, Shruti cannot order them. Shruti or nobody can order such satisfied souls. The satisfied wise people, nobody can order. But Shruti says that when such a student presents himself before you, then you should teach him. Why? Because there is no other way that he will be free from his problem. And you are the only people who can solve their problems. So that is why even Shruti orders them. In a way we can say. So here also Lord Krishna did not ignore Arjuna and began his teaching. And see, he understood. He is not, now in the next verse we will see that very beautifully Lord Krishna is not addressing his topical problem. He is not saying that you are going to win, fight, don't worry. No. What is he addressing, you will see. He is addressing his fundamental problem. The most important thing is to solve the fundamental problem. You don't know something. You don't know yourself. And because of that and from that, all these problems have arisen. So Krishna could see this. Bhagavan, not Krishna, but Bhagavan could see this. And he is addressing that. So now begins our verse. From here, the teaching really begins. So now, verse 11. See, in sadhana chatushtaya, just by the way, sadhana chatushtaya will be nitya anitya viveka, then vairagya, then shamati sattva sampatti. See, sadhana chatushtaya is fourfold qualifications which a student should have. Which are they? Viveka, vairagya, then shamati sattva sampatti and mumukshutva. In shamati sattva sampatti, again there are six qualities. Which are they? Shamaha, damaha, uparama, titiksha, shraddha and samadha. Shamaha means quietude of mind. Damaha means control over sense organs. Uparama means, you know, it has been, uparati means some kind of leisure of mind. And even of activities. You are ready for this. Titiksha means tolerance. Shraddha means faith. Not faith, but shraddha we cannot translate in English. A mood of the mind that which is now ready to listen, ready to listen to the words of the teacher and is ready to give the benefit of doubt. Ready to give a benefit of doubt to teacher's words. And samadhana. Samadhana means the mind has now solved all the major problems. Samadhana means whatever has happened in my life is okay. Prasada buddhi is also there. All that is there. That is samadha. Otherwise mind will keep on reacting. Why this? Why? With that reacting mind you cannot listen. So these qualities are required in a student. Only then and then he is fit to listen. Arjuna has got all this. And that is why, remember, that is why he could listen even in the midst of the battlefield. Otherwise he would say, no, please, Lord, please take me to that place. In the midst of these people, I cannot listen. But Arjuna could listen and very well, shows that he had all these qualities. Okay? This just by the way I wanted to mention. Hmm. Bhashyakara writes a very big bhashya before starting this. But we will not go into that, but straight, because Bhashyakara, Shankaracharya Ji Maharaj, who has written commentary upon this, he does not comment upon first chapter and first 10 verses of second chapter, because they are bhumika. They are important. It's not that it's not important. But he did not much bother about that, because he had, you know, he had a mission in life. He had to complete so many things. So he did not much indulge into this. And he began his commentary with the 11th verse, from where the teaching begins. Okay? So we will see that. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Ashochyanandvashochastvam Prajnyavadamscha Bhashase After Vadam, the Chodakshar is there. So, put a stress. Prajnyavadamscha Bhashase Gatasunagatasumscha Nanushochanti Pandita He says, now see, one more thing I forgot to tell you is Rishikeshah Tamuvacha Rishikesha Prahasanniva, with a little, as if he was smiling. Prahasanniva means as if he was smiling at Arjuna. More than smiling, there is some kind of mischief in his smile or laughter. Prahasanniva, as if he is making fun of Arjuna. That is how he replied. See, Sanjaya says, O King, Rishikesha replied, Rishikesha said these words to grieving Arjuna with a smile. Prahasan eva means as if making fun of him. Is he making fun? Prahasan, the word is there. Prahasan eva, as if making fun. Why should he make fun of Arjuna? Which means that Lord Krishna is not making fun, but seems to say, now you have come on the right track. Now you have come on the right track. Right track means now your life has begun. You are asking that which you ought to have asked long before. You ought to have asked me this long before. I was there with you all this time, but I was treated as a friend only. So far you treated me. Lord Krishna did not object to that. He enjoyed everything. Lord Krishna, Bhagavan was such a hasti. He enjoyed everything. And in fact, he never wanted to show himself as Bhagavan. Otherwise, they will put him on the pedestal, give him some bhoga, give him some flowers, and that is, he never wanted that. He wanted everything. He wanted to enjoy with Gopalas and everyone. So, Gopabala, etc. So he never wanted to be treated as Bhagwan, but he, at least he must have expected that I am not being used of. I possess so much. If they hear from me what they should hear, then their life will be made of. Their life will be made. But Arjuna never sought that. See, Arjuna never asked. That is also something which we can't understand. Why did Arjuna never ask for this knowledge? Nobody, even Yudhishthira also. None of the five Pandavas ever asked for this knowledge. They knew that he is Bhagavan. They knew that. But still, so see how it is, you know, that this time has to come. And this is something where each and everyone has to take initiative. This person has to work for on his own. Person has to take initiative. Even Bhagwan cannot do anything. he may create the situation. He may even himself be there. But unless and until you ask, what can Bhagavana do? And even if you say, even if you ask also, but if there is no heart behind that, then also it is not going to work. So, as if Lord Krishna was waiting for this situation or moment to come. This moment has to come in life. Unless it comes, things don't work. And I will tell you, such moments also come, but they don't strike us. There are so many situations in life. Life is full of problems. Life is full of difficult situations. Fundamental problem is always there behind. That you do not know the self is always there. And incidental problems also keep happening. They keep arising. But they come and go. They come and go. And we find some solutions. And they just pass. If they pass, nothing happens. But the problem should be such powerful that it should make you ask. And it should make you determine that no more. I will find a solution to this first, whatever happens. Nothing else is important in my life. See, Arjuna did this. Nothing doing. I will not fight. I will sit here only. This has to happen. And when this happens, then as if Lord Krishna said, this is what I was waiting for. Because now if I say, it will touch you. Otherwise, if I kept on giving pravachanas, it would not have touched you. Pravachana works when you are ready. You know, when you are ready, when the thing is hot and when you strike, then the shape will be there. You should strike when the iron is hot. There is a saying, strike when the iron is hot. Now Arjuna's iron is hot now. And that is why Krishna is laughing. Bhagavan is laughing. Because there is so much discussion about that. Why did he laugh? But he laughed. He should not. So there is so much. Tikakaras are thinking, why did he laugh at this time? Arjuna is crying and he is laughing. But he laughed. It happens, you know, our children sometimes cry. But parents laugh. It's not that they are making fun. Not like that. But now you will understand something. Now you will understand. So far I kept on study, but it never worked. It never worked. I was tired. My mouth, got over. But it never touched you. But now that fellow realized, I'll be thrown off. My friends are ahead of me. Something he saw in life. And that brought about the importance of study in his life. Similarly, Arjuna is now realized, my life is wasted so far. I have not acquired anything. So far I was wandering here and there. I was wandering. Intellect has been given to me. But I wasted away the intellect. The purpose for which this intellect has been given is not used for it. As Swamiji always says, he gives us the example of the touchstone. Touchstone is something, parasmani. Touchstone means it is such a thing that if you touch it to any other iron things also, then it turns into gold. So intellect is like a touchstone. It is given not for daily things. It is not given for mundane things. It is given for knowing the reality. It is given, it is because for knowing the reality, you require that subtlety of mind. You require the subtlety of intellect. And intellect is capable of that. Intellect is very subtle. Intellect is capable of turning this jiva from jiva to Shiva. It has that potential. Intellect has got, buddhi has got that potential, and it is meant for that. it is meant for that, you know, but such a sophisticated sadhana has been used for wealth, has been used for fame, has been used in other things, has been used for mundane things. For that you don't require this. But so far it was used for this, for controlling others, for finding other kinds of solutions. This Arjuna came to, that I have, and that is why he called himself a miser. See, this kind of intellect other beings do not have. And we as human beings also, everybody doesn't seem to have that. And this, that is why Bhagwan is smiling. Now is the time that you will, this life is meant for moksha. This life is meant for moksha only. Gita Shastra is moksha Shastra. And that you have asked for. And that is why he smiles. And then he said, this also I wanted to point out. And then he says, first of all he says, see, he started with the main teaching only. Not other things. As Swamiji says, he starts with the bang. He is addressing to the main problem only, main problem of life. Because if you solve this, you will be able to find solution to other things. So he says, Arjuna, there is no sentimentality in Bhagwana. He is not at all sympathetic. He is not at all sympathetic to Arjuna. He says, don't cry, beta. Arjuna, no such thing. He says, Ashochyan anvashochah tvam. He says, tvam means you are grieving for. Anvashochah means you are grieving for those who are not, who do not deserve to be grieved for. See, he says you are grieving for those who do not deserve to be grieved for. Ashochyan. How come? I am grieving for Bhishma, I am grieving for Dronacharya, I am grieving for my relatives, and you say they are not to be grieved for. He says, yes, nobody deserves to be grieved for, nobody deserves to be cried for. And on the other hand, you are giving me a lecture, you are talking in intelligent terms, you are giving me a big lecture. Prajna Vadamscha Bhashase. You talk like an intelligent fellow, and in reality you are grieving. What is wrong with that? Intelligent people do not grieve, or what? Intelligent people are not supposed to cry. He says they can cry, but not cry for this, not cry in such a matter. Gatvai gatasun agatasunscha. Gatasun means those who have gone. Agatasunscha, agatasunscha, agatasun. See, the word is gatasun, agatasunscha. Gatasun means those who have gone, those who are dead. Agatasun means those who are living, those who are alive now, and those who are dead. For both of this, for both this dead and alive, who do not grieve, he says, panditaha. Na anushochanti. Panditaha means intelligent people. Panditaha means those who possess the knowledge of the self. Panda. Panda means knowledge of self. Those who possess the knowledge of self are only called panditaha. Not the knowledge of words, but the knowledge which is imbibed. Knowledge which has become your own. Only then you may speak, but you may grieve also. So long the knowledge is not there. It doesn't mean that when somebody passes, some near and dear one passes away, and nothing happens to you. I don't mean to say that. And even Lord Krishna does. But see, temporarily you may be moved by a situation because the person has been there with you for such a long time. So some association is there. But we refuse to accept that. Why did he go away? He should not have gone. And this is not the right time. Why did God do this? we offer solutions to Lord. He should have taken me, or he should have taken that. This kind of nothing doing. Not being able to accept the reality temporarily is one thing, and not being able to accept it forever is another thing. Arjuna's case is the other one. Yeah? He refuses to accept that Bhishma should go or Dronacharya should go, and that too with my hands, at my hands. So this is not what a Pandita does. They do not cry. They do not grieve. Why? Because we will see tomorrow that grief occurs because of two things. Either you are not in a position to solve a problem, or you do not see any way out. He says, in both the ways, there is no reason for grief. See, death is inevitable. Death is something that is inevitable. That which is inevitable, for that also there should not be grief. And secondly, for Atma, there is no reason to grieve. Why? Because there is no death for Atma. Atma is not going to die. So that way also there is no grief. And the body is going to die. So that also is a fact of life. So where is the reason for grief? You are not living in reality. If you accept the reality, then also the reality, see, there are two kinds of reality. One reality is of anatma and one reality is of self. The reality of anatma, anatma means this matter, jada. The reality of anatma is that it is going to change. It is bound to change. And that reality you should accept. And the reality of the self is, it is imperishable, aksharam. That all will come. Na jayate mriyate. So if you live in this reality, where is the reason for grief? But grief arises when there is no readiness to accept the reality. When you resist the reality, say, put it in these words. When you resist reality, when you want the reality to be different from what it is, then there is reason for grief. Otherwise, there is no reason. And you are ignorant of this, and you pose as an intelligent person. You are talking in intelligent terms, but real intelligence is not there. You are grieving about Bhishma Pitam and Dronacharya. No. He says, sad vruttatvat paramartha rupena cha nityatvat. See, with respect to Bhishma Pitamaha and Dronacharya, sadvruttatvat. Sadvruttatvat means they are exemplary people. Their conduct has been beautiful. So after death also, they are going to have sadgati. Otherwise, we are worried about our people, you know. What will happen to them if they have not behaved properly in this life, then we may feel, where will they go? What kind of gati they will get? We are worried about that also. So Arjuna, you need not worry about Bhishma Pitam. Sat Vruttatvat, he is going to be liberated. Why are you worried? Even Bhishma, Dronacharya, they are the best of Brahmins. Bhishma Pitam is the best of Kshatriya. So they are going to go straight to heavens. So that way also there is no reason for grief. Then secondly, this is going to be the fate of their body. This body will go, body will perish here, and subtle body will be liberated, or it will go to heavens. So there also there is no reason for grief. And secondly, nityatvat. Nityatvat means self is imperishable. Nothing is going to happen to self. So why are you grieving? Tan, ashochyan, anvashochaha, anushochitavanasi. Te mriyante. What is the manner in which you are grieving? Te mriyante. Man nimittam. Aham tehi vina bhutam kim karishyami. This is the nature of they will die. Then I will be responsible for their death. Then what will I do without them? I'll be alone. There will be nothing left in my life. What will I do with this happiness? This is how you are grieving. See, Lord Bhagavana says that this kind of grief only in ignorant people do. What will I do without them? Where will they go? What will happen to me after in their absence? This is how we grieve, you know. What will I do when you go away? I'll be all alone. Who will take care of me? See, Mahatma says that nobody is grieving for others. Everybody is grieving for themselves only. Everybody grieves for their own selves. What will behind all this grief is concern for one's own self. What will I do without you? Who will take care of me? Who will be beside me when I become old? So many kinds of problems are there. So much insecurity is there. Behind all this is the care and insecurity, the concerns of insecurity for one's own self. People say this, who will take care of me? When you go away, I'll be all alone. Who will be my clutch, etc. So you be your clutch, but one cannot. See, so much of dependence in, there is so much of dependence in life. Not that you don't love other person, you do love. But behind all this love is the love of the self. Atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhava. So all this is there, which we will discuss tomorrow. And he says you are ignorant, and that is why that I have to address first. So Bhagavan will be addressing both the problems. He will be addressing the fundamental problem also, and after that he will address the topical problem. And then again he will say, in any one of this you need not grieve. Plus Arjuna, looking at both this you should fight. So this is how Bhagavan will be teaching. So tomorrow we have already entered into the teaching part, and we will proceed further. Wonderfully Bhagavan addresses Arjuna's problem. And this problem applies to, this teaching applies to us also. Because we may not have a situation like Arjuna, but death applies to us. We are also afraid of it and all that, and that is why this teaching is meant for us also.
Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vatvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah. Harihi.